all good people are asleep and dreaming.
Are men and women just a product of what hormones they have? Can a man take female hormones and become a woman, or vice versa? It's not that simple. Take a look at these animals. They are bilateral gynandromorphic hermaphrodites, which means they're half female and half male. When scientists studied a budgie with this condition, they discovered that on one side, every single cell was female, and on the other side, every single cell was male. Its plumage was split down the middle, it had both sex organs, and most importantly, it had equal amounts of male and female hormones. So what does this mean? Well, if the theory is that a male is only a male because of his hormones, and a female is only a female because of her hormones, and if you switch up the hormones, then you become the opposite, then there shouldn't be a difference between the two sides of the budgie's brain. What the scientists found instead was that the left side and the right side were completely different. One matched to normal female budgies, and one matched to normal male budgies' brains. The two sides of this hermaphrodite budgie's brain were different, even though they had the same amount of male and female hormones. The tissue was intrinsically different.
Well, I'm not a budgie. Well, who cares?
Well, in 2004, a team of scientists from the University of California, Michigan, and Stanford published findings that demonstrated that proteins derived from the X chromosome and Y chromosome of human male and female brains were incredibly different. For example, there are areas of the brain fully coded by proteins from the Y chromosome. Those proteins are absent in a female brain, and vice versa. They wanted to test this even further, so they gathered brain tissue from a mix of male and female participants. After analyzing the genes expressed in the brain tissue, the scientists were, with 100% success rate, able to identify the sex of each one of those participants. This demonstrates the effect of sex chromosomes on the brain tissue cannot be mediated by hormones. It's genetically programmed and present as soon as life begins. But don't get me wrong, this is not to discount the power hormones have. For example, there is a rare enzyme disorder called congenital adrenal hyperplasia. It occurs in about 1 out of 100,000 females, and it causes the fetus around 8 weeks to produce large amounts of testosterone from its adrenal glands. This exposure to testosterone does masculinize the girl. They make measurably less eye contact than girls without the condition, they're more prone to roughhouse play, and they exhibit less nurturing qualities. So hormones can't literally take someone from male to female or female to male, but they can bring someone closer to maleness or femaleness by changing the behavior and physical appearance to some degree. Another argument I've heard is, we're just hormones because we all start out as females in the womb. I understand where this myth comes from. I used to believe it too. But it only works if you define being female as lacking a penis. We do not all start out as female in the womb. We are either XX or XY, but physically we are non-specific. We do not have fully formed sex organs. Then around 6 weeks, if the embryo is XY, the SRY gene is triggered, which releases a surge of testosterone, which causes the male sex organs to form. The XY embryo is not female up to that point. It's still XY. It's still male. It just doesn't have its sex organs yet. Our sex is predetermined at conception. It's a pretty strict blueprint. But sometimes things don't go according to plan. The blueprint can be affected by things like endocrine disrupting chemicals, the mother's stress, or by accidental genetic anomaly. Basically, if the gene is not triggered because of genetic or environmental intrusion, the XY embryo will go on to form female genitals. But again, this does not mean we started out as female in the womb. This just means that nature is thrifty. It's easier to write one set of code with a switch than two completely different sets of code. I got realness, I just push it 'cause it's in my DNA.